Now let's look at how the distinction between static friction and kinetic friction applies to the rolling wheel. Assume that the wheel first occupies this position and then rolls on toward this position, a fraction of a second later. This would be the distance covered by the car. Let's mark the same distance on the perimeter of the wheel. So if the wheel was rolling without slipping, it would have rotated by this angle. But we want to study braking, so there will be a certain amount of slippage between the road and the wheel. The road will not turn by this complete angle, it will turn a little less. There will be a certain amount of distance left, marked in blue. This leads to the definition of wheel slip. Wheel slip is the ratio of that missing distance to the distance traveled by the car. If we have perfect rolling, there won't be any difference. The wheel slip becomes zero. We won't move at all. The blue distance equals the red distance and the wheel slip becomes one. Now one can study how friction depends on wheel slip. If the wheel slip equals one, the wheels are locked. They don't move with respect to the car. They slide on the street, which means that we are in the regime of kinetic friction. The coefficient of friction will be less than optimum. If the wheel slip equals zero, the wheel is rolling perfectly and the car only experiences the rolling friction, which is so small that we neglect it here and simply set the friction to zero. When there's just a slight amount of slippage between the wheel and the surface, the wheel develops the maximum friction. In what's going to follow, we are working with one single curve to describe how the coefficient of friction depends on the wheel slip. Actually, that's far from true. With a higher speed of the car, friction will be reduced. And of course, if there's water or ice on the street, we see a very strong reduction of friction. To keep things manageable, however, we are going to stick to one single curve.